Welcome to Section 51. This is Dos Geek, and you are watching, as usual, Section 51 on YouTube. Welcome to you. I hope you're fine. I hope you're safe, you're healthy. Thank you for coming to the channel every week. Thank you. Very happy to see you back on the channel for this new rendezvous, this new video. And today we're gonna talk about something mystical, something linked maybe to the stars, but it is here now, and for many years now, for many centuries and maybe millenaries, it is here on Earth. And of course, it must be linked to the stars and maybe to the ancient aliens, the ancient astronauts, some these civilizations, these people who visited us on Earth or visited our ancestors on Earth in the ancient times, in the old times. I would like to talk today about the Gate of the Gods, and in Spanish, the Puerta de Ayumarca. Okay? So, if you are ready to go with me, let's go now to the web. Now! Okay. So, we are back on the website Gaia.com. That's a very interesting website, I would say. And the article today is about Puerta de Ayumarca, the Gate of the Gods. It was published on March the 27th of 2020. And you will see that's a very interesting article. In the mountains of Peru, stands in South America, of course, stands a gateway shrouded in mystery and attributed with capabilities of mythic proportions. Many ancient sites on Earth are believed to hold special powers and emit unique frequencies of energy, lights, or sounds that otherwise seem impossible. Others old stories of people, cities, and even entire ships vanishing without leaving a trace. Stonehenge, the Bermuda Triangle, the Gate of the Sun in Tiwanaku, Bolivia, and many others caused even scientists to scratch their heads and admit that they aren't sure. Could these regions actually be portals to other dimensions, doorways known as stargates, through which humans as well as gods pass to and from this world to the next? But before this, let's start with the city of the gods. High in the mountains of Peru is home to one of these suspected stargates. Due to rocky mountain terrain and protection from the Peruvian government as an ancient archaeological site, it has gone vastly unexplored. Researchers still aren't certain whether or not this area actually contained a settlement. But the rock formations bear an interesting resemblance to dwellings and structures. The Gate of the Gods was discovered in 1996 by José Luis Delgado Mamani, a local tour guide who came upon the place as he hiked through the local foothills to familiarize himself with the area. As he approached the massive gateway nestled into the rock formation, he was overcome with recognition. He had seen this very gateway before in his dreams. It's like this other tour guide operator who was exploring the deep China and discovered the lost pyramids of Xi'an. We ever talked about them in an old video on the channel. I invite you to watch this video. It was another local tour guide. It was not a local tour guide. It was an American tour guide watching for new landscapes and new pictures, new sites to make discovered for the people in China. 4 years, a pink marble gateway with a smaller inset door from which emanated a mysterious blue light had presented itself to him while he slept, and the moment of discovery overwhelmed him almost to the point of fainting. How could this be just a fantastic coincidence?
So anything referred to as the gate of God or a navel of the earth is
a video sort of about the gate of God,
where the laws of physics are slightly different, or just so, that allows you to step through a portal to a level of existence.
There is one interpretation that would say perhaps there was something going on connecting different planets, different civilizations. And remember, the Sumerian accounts are of jealous gods, essentially, gods who are vying for influence and power.
Could mankind's ability to find these stargates be the next chapter in forwarding our understanding of the multidimensional universe we live in?
There's a stargate believed to be a similar doorway. It's in Turkey. There are others in Egypt. There are others in Iraq. And there are naturally occurring stargates in the American desert southwest that the native people talk about.
The legend of the Gate of the Gods. The native people of Lake Titicaca, Panu, and the rest of the surrounding region had long retold a myth about a mysterious doorway that led to the lands of the gods. Heroes in ancient times were witnessed entering into the beyond through this door to join their deities once their time on this earth had come to an end. The legend also mentioned these same great men re-entering through the same gate with their gods beside them to check in on the lives of those they had left behind. It also told of a prophecy. Someday in the future, the gate would open much bigger than it actually is and allow the gods to return to their sun ships. All of this and more raced through Mamani's mind as he beheld this magnificent structure outside of his dreams for the first time. This gateway was carved from the rock face, standing 7 meters high by 7 meters wide, with a smaller door inset at the base. In the center of the smaller door was a circular depression, and it was soon discovered that this alluded to yet another myth involving an ancient Incan priest fleeing for his life from Spanish conquistadors. The priest of Temple of the Seven Rays snatched up the precious golden disc known as the Key of the Gods of the Seven Rays when the pillaging pirates arrived to plunder everything for themselves and fled into the mountains of Ayumarca. He came across the Gateway of the Gods, which was being watchfully guarded by shaman priests. Whether in desperation for the fleeing priest's life or for protection for his people against the marauders, the shaman noticed the golden disc proved to fit perfectly into the moldy depression within the smaller door. They gazed in awe as the portal opened. Pale blue light bathed and the reddened rocks as it yawned wide. Lest the golden key is lost, the Incan priest Amaru Ramu relinquished it and stepped through the gateway, never to be seen again. Once he recognized the portal from his dreams, Mamani immediately contacted archaeological experts in the surrounding villages of La Paz, Puno, and Lima, and within hours the site was crawling with Inca historians and scientists who were familiar with the legends swirling about the area. Despite allegations of the gateway being a portal to other worlds, whether leading to numerous tunnels harbored inside the mountain or capable of transporting humans and other beings into other dimensions, the scientists remained skeptical. The gate appeared to be carved as one structure from the rock with no gap that would indicate it as a door being visible. According to some of the research party, by placing their hands on the door, they could feel energy pulsing from the inside. Some heard strange rhythmic music. Others claimed they saw visions of columns of fire and things beyond this world. What struck the scientists most was that the massive doorway bore striking resemblance to another structure attributed to Stargate capabilities, the Gate of the Sun in Tiwanaku, Bolivia, as well as five other archaeological points, all connected in a grid-like pattern whose lines intersected exactly where the plateau and Lake Titicaca happened to be. Locals also claim to have witnessed significant UFO activity, such as twinkling blue lights and white glowing disks. Signs of ancient advanced technology in Peru, or something even more out of the ordinary? The majority of these sites remain vastly unexplained by modern science, and perhaps that's a large part of their allure. Whether alien portals to alternate universe, passages through which gods can reappear and humans can disappear, or simply an ancient structure designed for rituals and worship, these strange formations continue to intrigue us thousands of years later. This is the Peruvian Stargate. September 1996, a huge mysterious door-like structure was discovered in the Ayumarca mountain region of southern Peru. Ayumarca, 35 kilometers from the city of Puno, has long been revered by local Indians as the city of the gods, and has never been fully explored because of the rugged mountain terrain. Although no actual city has ever been discovered, many of the rock formations of the region resemble buildings and artificial structures. The door, or the Puerta de Ayumarca, Gate of the Gods, has been at some time in the distant past carved out of a natural rock face and in all measures exactly 7 meters in 8 by 7 in width, with a smaller alcove in the center at the base, which measures in at just under 2 meters in 8. This is the door. Very intriguing. Others have said that they have perceived tunnels on the interior of the structure, so nobody as yet has found a gap that would illustrate the door opening. On the contrary, the professional opinion is that there is no actual door for the frame and the entranceway and the back of the alcove are all carved from the same rock. Here this is the Gate of the Sun at the winter solstice. The Gate of the Sun at Tiahuanaco and five other archaeological sites which link together by grid lines intersecting each other exactly at the point where the plateau and Lake Titicaca is located. And here this is a close-up on the Gate of the Gods. Very strange, and you can see the shape, the round shape, the disc shape in the center. Very strange. So this was This was very interesting, very strange. I like that kind of story, that kind of subjects. I guess I even saw, I even watched a documentary on the channel. It was Discovery Channel, maybe. During a TV show, it must be the TV show called Ancient Aliens, maybe. But however, that's very interesting, and I'm very curious. What do you think about all this? Do you think that's very true? That the Puerta de Ayumarca could be a gate, a stargate? Could it be an interdimensional portal? Could it be a stargate used by our gods, by ancient astronauts, to come to Earth and to go back to leave Earth, and maybe sometimes bringing with them some human slaves? Personally, I don't know. I would like that it would be true, because in terms of writing stories for fiction, that's very rich, that's a gold mine. And for me, who is writing some science fiction stories and science fiction comics, I am very interested by these subjects. So what do you think of this? And if it was true, if the gates, if the stargates existed in the past, if you were living in the past, in the old times, would you have been a volunteer to go with the gods on their own planet? That leads to a lot of possibilities in terms of scenario, of story. That's amazing. So thank you guys for watching. This was Dos Geek on Section 51. I hope you liked this new video. I hope you liked the subject. Don't forget to like, to share, to subscribe to Section 51. I'm a bit tired. I think I'm going to bed now in the spaceship. My bed is here, right here. And sometimes it's hard to sleep because of the noise of the spaceship. But we keep moving. We keep moving. We are still cruising through the space. Maybe one day we will be able to explore a new planet. So thank you for watching. Keep watching Section 51. This was Dos Geek. Live long and prosper. And until the next video, stay safe and keep your eyes open. Look at the sky. Bye!